We've already shown you that the 14-inch MacBooks absolutely smoke the Intel MacBook Pros, but what about the latest and greatest from Microsoft, Intel, and Nvidia? Well, today, that's what we're doing. We're comparing the new Microsoft Surface Laptop Studio against the 14-inch M1 Pro MacBook Pro in a variety of tests, such as CPU and GPU performance, design, webcams, speakers, 3D rendering, photo and video editing, thermal performance, and battery life. Now, we are starting off with 100% on both of these machines. I'm gonna go ahead and unplug them, and as we go through and run all of these tests, it's gonna be very interesting to see how these stack up. Now, the Surface Studio is an amazing machine. We really like it, and it actually costs $100 more than the banned 14-inch MacBook Pro while having the same SSD and RAM. Let's start by comparing the external differences, and as you guys see, the footprint on the Surface Studio laptop is slightly larger. It is a bit longer and wider. And even though everybody's calling the new MacBooks thick boys, check out the Surface Studio. It's even thicker. Now that is because of the hinge. I will show that off in just a bit. But first, let's compare the ports. On the right-hand sides, the Surface has their Microsoft Connect charger, which can also support other Microsoft devices with the headphone jack, and the MacBook now gives us an HDMI port, an SD card reader, and a full bandwidth Thunderbolt 4 port. On the left side, the MacBook gives us that MagSafe charging port, a high impedance headphone jack, as well as two Thunderbolt 4 ports, which the Surface also has. When was the last time that a MacBook actually had a better port selection? That is awesome for Mac lovers. Now, I did mention high impedance headphone jack. Apple really made that a big deal. So we finally get to test it because we have a Windows laptop here. We have these Sennheiser headphones, which aren't particularly high. They're 50 ohms. Some go up to 100, 300, 600. It's crazy. But we're gonna play a song for you guys. You can hear the difference of the volume. That is completely maxed out. And now let's switch to the MacBook. I'm excited to hear if we have a difference. Wow, that is definitely a lot louder. Now, if these were 100 ohms or 300 ohms, the difference would be much bigger. The MacBook could still play them at full volume, so it's great for those of you guys who like your headphones. And if you're somebody that loves little tidbits like this here at MacTech, make sure you're subscribed and you guys can help us reach our goal of 1 million subscribers before the end of the year. That would be amazing. Taking a look at the insides, we have Windows Hello on the Windows. It already saw me right there, and I can just press the space bar to log in. And then if the cover's closed, a lot of times it'll just log you in automatically, which is amazing. On the MacBook, we do have that notch, but no Face ID. We have Touch ID right here, so I can put my finger there. It logs me in right away. Now, we will be comparing the displays here in just a bit, but first, let's take a look lower. We have great keyboards with both of these. They're top-notch. I can't choose which one I like best. The Windows keyboard is excellent, and going lower, the trackpad on the Surface Laptop Studio is the best trackpad I've used on a Windows machine. It's also magnetic, force touch magnets, whatever they call it, just like the MacBook, and it feels awesome. The MacBook's is slightly better. It's slightly larger. You can adjust the feedback it gives you, which is really nice, but both are excellent. Now, the sides of the Mac keyboard, we have speaker grills for the up-firing speakers, where on the Microsoft Surface, it is down-firing, but it's great because right now we're on a desk, so it really helps. And these speakers we already know are fantastic from our previous videos, and now let's just go ahead and see how they compare to the new 6-speaker system in this 14-inch. All right, guys, wow, what a difference. That is crazy. The Surface Laptop Studio is insanely loud, probably even louder than the 16-inch MacBook Pro, at least when you have it on a desk and the sound can bounce. Now, as far as sound quality, the 14-inch is a lot more balanced and it has way more bass. It sounds like this thing has much louder speakers, but no sub at all or a woofer for the lower frequencies, whereas this one has nice deep bass, but it definitely is a lot quieter. So if you want something that is insanely loud, get this one, it's incredible. If you want something that's still loud, but sounds better, the MacBook wins.
Apple finally upgraded to 1080p webcams on the new 14 and 16 inch MacBook Pros. So here is the quality from that, along with what they call studio quality microphones.
And here is Microsoft's 1080p webcam with their microphones. You guys let me know which one looks better and sounds better in this nice studio lighting environment.
And here's how the MacBook looks in a lower light environment, like most people have at their homes.
And this is Microsoft's 1080p webcam in the same lower light environment. Make sure to let me know which one looks better and sounds better below.
And now let's get into the displays, where we have a ton of differences. The first one is the resolution. We have a 3x2 display with the Surface and a 16x10 with the MacBook, but the MacBook does have that notch, and Apple, instead of taking space away, gave us a little bit of extra space where that menu bar is now, that is added on. Now we have a resolution difference. We have about 3.8 million pixels for the Surface compared to 5.9 for the MacBook. So it's crazy that Apple upped the resolution. It now has a lot more pixels, which means it does drain more battery power. Now with that, the Surface drains more power because it has a 120 hertz display, whereas Apple also has 120 hertz, but it is ProMotion, so it could go all the way down to 24 hertz to save battery life. And they could also adjust for different frequencies if you want something custom. Now the MacBook also supports DCI P3 wide colors, which means you have a better display for color grading and editing compared to sRGB only on the Surface, and it's also only 8-bit compared to 10-bit. Now the Surface does have a benefit, and that is the fact that it is a touchscreen, and not only that, it also has pen support and this super unique hinge, if I can get it to pop open, where you can have a couple different layouts. You can have it magnetized right here if you want to do some drawing, or you can actually lay it all the way flat like this if you want to use it more like a tablet. And that is something that Apple does not offer at all with their MacBooks. They want you to buy an iPad Pro. Now, an absolutely huge difference is display reflectivity. Apple has amazing coatings on theirs, whereas Microsoft, it is just extremely glossy, almost like a mirror finish. So that means that dark colors and contrast is lowered because of that. And if you use it outside or in a brighter room, it's very reflective. Now, the main brightness for standard content is the same on both, but because of that reflectivity, it makes it hard to use. Now, when you're watching HDR content, that is when the MacBook screen really shines, because instead of being capped at that pretty good 500 nits, it goes up to 1,000 sustained, or 1,600 peak. Now this video is no more than 1,000, so it can get even brighter, but it's crazy how much all of the highlights pop while the shadows stay perfectly black instead of being gray on this, which looks like a much flatter image. Now in dark environments, you could definitely notice blooming with the MacBook's display, especially if you have pure black with really bright highlights like with these menu bars. But on the Surface, you pretty much have blooming across the whole screen because it's one single backlight. It's not as distracting because it's everywhere, but you see this gray where all the blacks are. But with that said, the difference when you're watching stuff like this is huge. You have the bright pops of colors, great contrast, and watching movies is just awesome with this screen and of course the speakers. And now let's get into performance. We're gonna start out by testing the SSDs. And here are the results, and the MacBook's SSDs are 3 times faster, both for their write speed and their read speed. And this is not the only difference. When we were transferring over our PC test folder, we noticed that after 50 gigabytes, it slowed down to a super slow 300 megabytes per second. And because of that, it took 12 minutes to transfer the folder compared to 2 minutes and 46 seconds on the MacBook. So the MacBooks have much better SSDs with much higher SLC cache, and that test was actually limited by that Thunderbolt drive for the MacBook, not its crazy fast SSD. And now let's test out the CPU performance. I have Geekbench 5 opened up, and I want to let you guys know once again that we have the binned version. This is the 8-core version, not the 10-core, so we're missing 2 out of the 8 performance cores. Now both have 16 gigs of RAM, and the Intel model here is the i7-11370H. It only came out a few months ago. This is the latest and the most powerful, up to 4.8 gigahertz compared to being capped to 3.2 with the Mac. But now let's go ahead and see the result. Now we are still on battery power, and one great thing about the Surface Studio is the fact that it does not slow down when you unplug it like many other Windows laptops, both for the CPU and the graphics. All right, guys, we have a result, and the Surface actually did really well. Look at that single core of 1544. That's quite high. That's only about 15% less than the M1 Pro chip here. But on the multi-core, even with the binned version that's missing performance cores, we have a difference of 70%. So we have a lot better performance with the M1 Pro 14-inch MacBook. Now let's go ahead and minimize this, and we are gonna take a look at the graphics, because this Surface that costs $100 more actually has dedicated graphics. We have the RTX 3050 Ti graphics. Now, I actually thought that this was a 3060 in here, because Microsoft doesn't tell you, they just say RTX. And of course, we didn't want to buy the $2,700 one that has a little bit more powerful graphics, but still, this is dedicated and I think it should be really good. And bam, look at that, guys. That NVIDIA graphics card is giving us way more performance. That is 74% more powerful. And keep in mind, we're on battery power. So the Surface is very impressive that it could give us full performance while being unplugged, just like the MacBook. But in just a bit, we will test this out in real world workloads as far as like video editing, photo editing. But first, what about gaming? We know that this machine has all the games on there with Windows 11. So I'm gonna run 3D Mark's gaming test. This is Wildlife Extreme Unlimited, and it's gonna be the off-screen mode. That way resolutions don't go into play. It's just pure gaming graphics performance. And wow, guys, look at this. This time the tables flipped. We have 9,200 for the 14-inch MacBook compared to 8,050 for the 3050 Ti. Now, with Geekbench, it tests like 30 different tasks, and they've said that the scores are actually low because it finishes the task so quick that it can't ramp up the graphics all the way. But here for optimized gaming, even the 14-core binned graphics from the M1 Pro perform better. Now, of course, we have the great hardware now, but we don't have a lot of metal optimized games. Now we have to just wait and see if we'll ever get great games for the Mac. So we just maxed out that GPU, and now let's max out the CPUs using Cinebench, and I have my thermal camera here, and we're starting the 10-minute stress test. I have Intel Power Gadget opened up here, and we just hit 49 watts on battery power, basically 50 right there, right over 50 watts, where with our M1 Mac, we hit a peak CPU power of 23.8 watts, running at only 21 watts right now, compared to almost 53. That is crazy. Now, shout out to Timothy Leo for creating this script, this visual that makes it much easier than what we were doing before. After a minute and a half, our M1's fans are still off, whereas the Surface spun up after about a minute, the wattage dropped, and we hit 100 degrees Celsius. Now, the Surface has a beast of a cooling solution. There's vents everywhere, it has great fans, and it runs really quiet, just like the M1 Max. We have those new top vents that make airflow much better, side vents, updated fans, so we have great cooling on both. And with this, even on battery power, as soon as it cooled down a little bit, it jumped up back to 40 watts. 88 degrees Celsius. Now our Mac's running a little bit hotter. We're looking at 95 watts, and the fans are only running at maybe 20% completely silent, whereas the Surface, they're still super quiet, but you can hear them. So we have 1 minute left of this test. Let's check out the thermal camera. We're seeing 44 degrees Celsius on the MacBook at that hot spot in the center, and the Surface, we have a hot spot towards the right side. Look, 39, 40 degrees Celsius. It's definitely running cooler. That's a good noticeable difference. And that's because Microsoft is ramping up these fans. They're audible after the 5 minute mark. They got a lot louder compared to Apple, which their fans are still silent. So they are prioritizing running these Macs really quiet. All right, guys, the scores are in, and we have 5,962 for the Windows laptop, which is an excellent score for it, compared to 8,962 for the M1 Pro. Now, that is a difference of 50%, but what we notice is that is actually a very low score. If you guys look over here, we were getting about 9,500, And then we did a couple tests using this new tool that we're using to gauge the wattage and frequencies, and it's quite a bit lower each time we ran it. So in reality, we shouldn't use this tool while we're trying to get a final score. So if we go off of the previous one, that's actually a difference of 60% between the Surface and the Mac. So we have about half the power draw on the Mac and about 60% more performance, which is absolutely crazy. And with that said, let's get into some other real world tests. And next, we are gonna test Blender. I have the Party Tug demo file opened up right here. The lighting is pre-compiled when we opened it up, and now we're gonna go ahead and render it. Now this does use graphics, so this thing has that 3050 Ti that should be really powerful compared to the binned 14 core. Let's go ahead and click render. And bam, look at this, guys. We have 9.72 seconds for the 14 core binned M1 Pro compared to 7.86 for that RTX 3050 Ti. That's a difference of about 23% faster. Now, as far as I know, you can't use the GPU rendering for everything. So here's this project called Splash Fox that you can also test on your system. Uses mostly the CPU. Let's go ahead and see how long it takes. And look at that. Both of them are 25 seconds with the Surface edging it out by what, 0.4 seconds maybe? Very fast. Of course, this has the 4.8 gigahertz peak boost that it can do little short bursts of, and that helps a ton. And in this real world Blender render, the time is the same, which is awesome. Now, I do wanna mention that Apple is working with Blender to create a whole new backend with full native Metal support. That's gonna make Blender a lot faster on these new systems. And now let's get into photo editing. I have Lightroom Classic opened right here, and I have 42 megapixel images opened. And as we flip through, both are very, very responsive. Might be slightly faster sometimes on the M1 because of the faster SSD. As far as cropping in, a little bit smoother once again on the M1 Pro when we're zooming into these raw images with a bunch of effects. But now I'm gonna go ahead and select all of these images. We're gonna export all 50 to JPEG. And bam, we are exporting. I got my timer hit, and it's gonna be interesting to see if we have any differences because of the ultra fast unified memory on the M1 Pro compared to standard DDR4 with the Surface. And wow, this M1 Pro 14 inch is flying. All right, the tests are done, and the Surface took 2 minutes and 50 seconds compared to 1 minute and 44 seconds. So that's about 65% faster with the MacBook Pro. Not only that, the fans were off the whole time compared to getting pretty high on the Surface. Now, it's still pretty quiet. It's not super obnoxious, which is great, but they were spinning at the higher end of what they could do to get this test done as quickly as it did. Now, of course, that was with just Lightroom open, nothing else in the background. What I'm really curious about is how do these systems perform if you actually have, say, 5 or 10 Chrome tabs open, maybe another background application. So if you guys wanna see a RAM comparison between 16 gigs of unified RAM and 16 gigs of standard DDR4, make sure you guys enable those notifications, and you're also make sure that you're subscribed, because I'm gonna make that video and I think it's gonna be very interesting. And now let's get into video editing. Of course, you cannot run Final Cut on the Surface, so I have DaVinci Resolve opened up, which is really well optimized on both. And for standard projects, both of these are gonna handle H.264 footage. I have a couple LUTs applied here, some film grain, no problems. I'm gonna test something a little bit tougher, but first, let's go ahead and export this. Let's start the render for this 5 minute project. Of course, people are talking about how crazy the encoders are with these new systems. Now, keep in mind, this is the base 14 core, and it's not the max, it has double the encoders. And NVIDIA also has their own encoders that are very good. The fans on the Surface are spinning at the max. It's probably the loudest I've heard them. And we could see that our NVIDIA GPU is pretty much maxed out. 97, 95%, 96. So it's maxed out, CPU's at 41. Whereas the M1 Max, look at that. It's about 50% or so, 53% graphics. So the graphics card is not our limitation right now. The CPU is only at 19%, 20%. The fans are off. And look how cool it's running. This is crazy. I don't think I've seen it this low. 60 degrees, 59 degrees. The graphics is at 59 degrees. That's because those encoders are actually the limitation. It would go even faster if it had the M1 Max encoders. Where on the Surface, the graphics is actually a limitation. Man, I feel like a vibration here now from these fans and heat's blowing on our MacBook. Interesting that we ran this test and are seeing such big differences. And bam, our N1 Pro is done. Let's wait for the Surface here. We still have about another minute or so. Oh man, the GPU is throttling now at 50%. The project was almost done. It literally had 1 minute left and then it started throttling and now it's gonna take longer. That is because we hit 20% battery. Right now we're at 19. Even though right now my battery saver is turned off, it's still limiting graphics performance to only half of what it should be. I guess we'll see how long it takes. It's still finishing up in not too much time, but we only had 1 minute left and it was very consistent. So the Surface finished in 4 minutes and 26 seconds. It didn't slow down actually that much. Still would have been over 4 minutes if it didn't decide to slow itself down. Whereas our M1 took 2 minutes and 54 seconds. Now, unfortunately, I have to plug in this system because it's no longer giving me full performance. Even with the power savings turned off, I guess under 20%, or if you hit 20, you no longer get your full performance, which kind of sucks. So let's go ahead and just talk about battery life. We started at the beginning. We did a lot of stuff with the screens and speakers, all of that. Both were at 100%. And then now we are at 17%. Jeez. On the Surface, whereas our M1 Pro, you guys actually go ahead and comment, let me know below, what do you think our 14-inch M1 Pro MacBook is at? It is at 56%. Wow. We have more than 3 times the battery left in here, and overall, it is more than twice as good, or it's getting close to twice as good. Now, of course, only like half of this test was performance testing, and this is where the Surface really started draining compared to, you know, web browsing and speakers and stuff like that. So in reality, most likely, if you're really pushing these systems, you'll probably get at least 2 to 3 times better battery life with the M1. And of course, we saw that in our CPU wattage and the graphics takes a lot more power. So that's a pretty significant difference. Now, if you want more video editing tests, we are actually gonna be comparing to a 3080 Razer against the M1 Max. We'll do a lot more tests in that one. But I think for video editing, this is actually the test that I thought the Surface would win at because it has really good encoders as well. If you're getting into tougher stuff, then stuff like, for example, like ProRes, there's encoders and decoders for that as well. So optimization-wise for video editing, I think the MacBook is definitely the way to go. Even with a 14-core binned 14-inch MacBook, it's doing a killer job. So with all of those tests completed, is it worth spending $100 more for the Microsoft Surface compared to the MacBook? Now, I'll say once again, this is an excellent Windows device. And if I was gonna buy a Windows laptop that's a smaller, more portable machine, this would probably be it. It's an awesome machine. But with that said, it's expensive. When the quality went up, the price also went up. So is it worth spending $100 more compared to the MacBook? Well, I think in my book, obviously I'm a fan, I like Final Cut Pro, but when you take a look at the quality of the speakers, when we take a look at that webcam, how fast SSDs are, the performance of that CPU and the graphics, and the battery life that's included as well, this is just an incredible package, and even the binned version that costs $100 less still performs fantastic. But you guys let me know your thoughts down below. What stood out to you the most and which one would you buy? I wanna hear your guys' opinion. And thank you guys for watching. Click that circle above to help us reach our goal of 1 million subscribers. We would definitely appreciate it. Check out one of those great videos right over there. This has been Max, and I will see you in the next video.